Hello and welcome. The lockdown is lifting across the country and more so in big cities like Mumbai and Delhi. The problem is that even as the lockdown is lifting, the number of cases continues to rise. As the number of cases continues to rise, so does the fear and apprehension amongst the people living in them. Now, equally, after 75 to 90 days of being locked down, many people want to step out and interact with the world, including allowing people to enter their homes, and that includes domestic help, which many associations and societies are not doing. So what happens now? And what can residents' associations and societies do to play a more proactive role going ahead to fight coronavirus? To discuss this, I'm joined by Ramesh Prabhu, chairman of the Maharashtra Society Welfare Association, and Atul Goyal, president of the United Resident Joint Action Committee and an umbrella association of 2,500 resident welfare associations in New Delhi. So first question, as the lockdown has lifted, now Mumbai has lifted a little after Delhi, but Delhi has already lifted and is seeing a rise in cases. How are resident welfare associations in Delhi approaching it in terms of the traffic that you are permitting within your associations and the interaction that you're permitting between your associations and the outside world? Mr. Goyal.
If I speak frankly with you, the position of resident welfare associations in Delhi, they are scared as well as of the actions taken or relaxations by the government, as well as they are quite apprehensive about saving their lives. So both things are going hand because Delhi's RWAs are always been proactive on the matters of governance. And this time also, when this epidemic blown in Delhi and the containment zones, which were earlier 99, they reduced to 65, and now it is coming up to around 250 or so. So this type of multiplication in the city, and we have been demanding from the government from time to time since this corona lockdown began sometime in March, and that the government must come up with the neighborhood data or ward level data, so that I must be aware of what is happening in my neighborhood, which the government of the day has not come forward so far. They are managing the whole of the scenario at the district level, and district authorities, that is the district magistrate, is not coming forward with the statistical data available at their end.
Right. So that's one part of the problem. But how are you seeing it, and I'm sure a lot of residents are asking you that, you know, can we allow the maids to come in? Can we have our family members visit us? So what is your response to that?
There is a clear division in this concept, because for the namesake, RWA, it looks like a one single name, but it is being guided by different organizations. It is being guided under and registered under different organizations.
Right.
Like, say, group housing societies, they have a single entry gate and exit gate. And if you go for the planned city, which is a plotted colony, it has multiple entry gates, not less than 8 to 10 entry gates, sometimes more than that.
Right.
And now in Delhi, there is another chapter added to this, that is underdeveloped colonies. Earlier it was unauthorized colonies, now it is underdeveloped colonies. Then there is a walled city. Then there is a JJ cluster, Jugi cluster, slums. So all these areas are guided by different permutation combinations of a RWA governance method. And they are guided by different sections. We are registered with 1860 Societies Registration Act. But group housing societies are registered with the Cooperative Group Housing Societies Act. DDA housing is registered with the DDA housing set. So there is a clear gap. And particularly the people, those who are residing in a group housing society, those who are having a cooperative setup, they sometimes come up with some highly objectionable attitude and violation of the guidelines of the government of the day. And we see that, because they are also projecting and coming up in the name of RWA, so it is being projected as if whole of the bunch of RWA is behaving
So can you give me an example of this objectionable, let's say, guideline that you are disagreeing with?
See, and one of the group housing society in Delhi NCR, what happened, there were few paramedical staff which was coming to their residence after providing the government services. And these people were not allowed to enter and move to their flat. And the society people, society officials said that you have to go out and remain outside for 14 days. Then only we will be allowed. So this type of dictation, you cannot take the rule in your RWS exact formation is there to serve the members, to take care and to connect with the governance. They are directly violating those norms.
Okay, great. So, Mr. Prabhu, what's your reading of what's happening right now in Mumbai, where I am too? You know, different societies are responding differently. Some are allowing maids and domestic help. Some are not allowing. Some are allowing people to visit senior citizens. Others are not allowing. So I know it. There cannot be consistency because every society will respond differently. But how are you seeing it from at a more macro level?
Sir, very upset to say that housing societies have started behaving like a dictator. Mm-hmm. So this is not what has been, emphasized or expected. Housing society is there to manage and maintain the common areas, to take care of the parking or the, entry, securities, all that. Now, because of the lockdown, on 26th of March 2020, collector of the district and the district registrar, in every district, the district registrar has given a guideline to the housing society that since there is a lockdown, nobody should be allowed to come inside and nobody should go outside unless and it is related to essential services. Taking that as a clue, once the lockdown has been opened up, that is a mission begin again from 1st of, June 2020, it was expected that housing society should allow the easy entry of the visitors, easy entry of the maids, easy entry of the carpenters, civil contractors, shifting of the tenants, all this should be allowed. However, at the same time, it cannot be allowed just like that. There has to be certain guideline followed. What could be the guideline? All the precautionary measures to take care of sanitizing the person who is coming there or, allowing the maids or maids with the non-contournment area. Contournment areas should not be allowed. So many precautions, maybe taking the fever checking they can do. So many things can be done. But instead of doing all this, what they are saying is, now the registrar has not given a proper order of lifting his order and government has not given us a clarity. How much clarity you want? So therefore, we had arranged a Zoom meeting of 650 people to take the views, and we had invited the doctors, but it has been discussed openly that no, this type of dictatorship cannot be done by the housing societies. It is an unfortunate thing. However, still some societies are following that, and we are right. Really finding it difficult. We have represented to the government, we have represented to the MCGM to give a clarity, which we are expecting very shortly.
Right. So, Mr. Goel, can I come back to Delhi for a moment? So, I know similarly in many societies, you must be allowing and not allowing. But what's the thinking? I mean, I know there is fear. There is fear everywhere. At the same time, we obviously want to move on as long as we take the right precautions. So, it's also a legal issue in some ways. I mean, if I'm a resident, I live in my own apartment, which I have paid for, then to what extent can I be prevented from doing something when the which is either the state government or the municipality has already given a certain green signal. So how are associations responding to that in Delhi?
The RWS in Delhi are not violating. They want to fall in line and work along the guidelines of the government on the particularly in case of the COVID. Now the question comes whenever there is a black sheep and whole of the lot is tinted black, then there is a murmur. People speak about the bad thing first and the good thing later. And to overcome this, we had number of times advocated in Delhi that the government must recognize and come forward with a RWS Act, where the guidelines and the frame and the memorandum of association, rules and regulations under which they operate, must be clearly spelled out.
You're saying, Mr. Goel, because there is no law, people are beginning to apply law very much like Mumbai?
Absolutely, because Delhi is also, you see, whole of the country is no different than others. Everyone fall in the same, the thought process of the Indians are the same. and we are ready to violate the laws first, then to fall in line with the law. So this tendency of Hindustani quality, or what you say, the leadership of the mindset of the community leaders, is highly disturbing. And our organization's role is that we must curb this type of tendency wherever the community leadership does this exist. We must curb it down with strong hands.
Right. So, Mr. Prabhu, what is the, you know, so let's say I live in a society where, you know, so I mean, again, I'm saying this is the government, in this case, the or the Municipal Corporation of Mumbai has lifted partially the lockdown, has clearly said that, let's say, so-and-so people can come in, so-and-so people can come out, and yet my society is not doing it. So do I have legal recourse here?
Sir, definitely there is a legal recourse. Once the lockdown has been opened up, which means that there is an easy movement of the people. Fundamentally, and as per the Constitution of India also, nobody can stop access to anybody's house. So maid is an employee whom you are taking, so or your visitors are visiting. So these are your access to the flat. There is an entry, common entry from the, no doubt, a compound of the society. But they can maintain the entry, they can regulate the entries, they can do whatever the precautionary measure they want. But stopping somebody over there, it becomes a criminal offense. It is fundamental. According to the Constitution of India, according to the law of the land, it is not permitted. Even under the IPC, it becomes restraining somebody the entry which is otherwise available. Just to give you an example, in Mumbai, can anyone buy a house which is in the open land? No. It has to be in the housing society only, because that is how the entire setup is. So therefore, housing society cannot stop the common entry. It is like, you know, having a highway and somebody is stopping the highway. No, it cannot. So this way, this is an access route, and therefore they are violating the very fundamental of the IPC.
Okay, Mr. Goyal, how do you see this going forward? You know, for instance, now, I mean, there are rumors, this is not true, but there are rumors, for instance, that there will be another lockdown. Obviously, that is driven by fear. People are speculating wildly. Yeah. Now, and this is obviously going to increase the concern levels in your RWA. So how do you see the next, you know, couple of weeks or even month going ahead? I mean, what is the equation going to be? Are you going to continue to allow people in?
We have issued number of advisories. We have come up with the number of SOPs to the RWAs, to the general public, even to the government officials and the politicians, those who are in power, that how to control this pandemic situation with our own expertise, with our own intellect. And we have published all those documents. I don't know whether you have the access to those documents. If you don't have, I will send it across to you also. It's not an issue. And our fear is now in Delhi, since the surge of infected people is increasing in such a quantum that RWAs, we have proposed 2-3 methodologies to avoid and fill the gap between getting a hospital bed and reaching out to the bed. That time period, and we have advised 2-3, let's say, you can have a room, a separate room, where you can keep 3-4 beds over there, and oxygen cylinder or oxygen generators over there. And those people who are converting from asymptomatic to symptomatic, they are in need of a oxygen first. They don't want ventilator straight away. So that time gap, they can be stationed over there. Or secondly, we have advised these people that they can be kept at home quarantine, and we can provide them with an oxygen concentrator or oxygen cylinder, and provided that there is an attached bathroom, whatever the norms are, medical norms are there, we must follow the medical norms, not in violation of the medical norms. But that will basically lessen the burden.
So the government authorities are doing this already, Mr. Goyal?
This concept is picking up in Delhi like fire in a jungle. And more and more RWAs are prompted towards working on this concept. I think for the time being, if I count out, it must be more than around 40 to 50 RWAs must have made arrangements for such a thing.
That includes a secluded space, beds, oxygen tanks.
Yes. Okay. Yeah, people are working on those lines.
Okay. Mr. Prabhu, are we seeing anything similar in Mumbai?
In Mumbai, more than 5 to 7 societies have started doing this type of isolation ward. And very honestly, on 6th of June 2020, the Maharashtra government also came out the revised guideline for the home isolation. And having seen this, and when the many societies started implementing voluntarily this type of isolation wards, converting their refuse areas into the what is known as isolation areas, then their clubhouses into isolation areas, then the on 9th of June, that is about 3 days back, 9th of June 2020, MCGM has come out with a guideline as to how a refuge area also can be converted, how club area and open areas can be converted, how a you can buy take on a rental premises a certain area, flat or one bedroom, two room flat, and that can be converted. So now it has been given an official stamp by the MCGM, and because of which nowadays I have started receiving the call from bigger societies saying that we have clubhouse, how to convert it, what are the precautions to be taken, what are the other requirements. So I think now it has started picking up, and it is a good sign, because now the way the corona is going to increase, at least society as a community should be able to help our own members. And I think this is one of the best move that I have seen. It's a positive move, I would say.
Right. Okay, last question to you both. Mr. Goyal, let me begin with you. So to come back to the next few weeks or a month, what are the key challenges that you see ahead, and how should or how will you be, or your associations be responding to them?
One of the major key challenges is to control the spread in the city and prompt the government to behave responsibly and to do all those things which are required of them, which so far is not in the delivery process. That is one part of our advocacy. We are writing to these government officials. We are writing to the chief minister. We are writing to the LG, all the government higher officials, that they must come forward with the proper guidelines, which are framed by these people only. So we are asking them to first get their house in order before raising a finger on the others. On the other side, we are prompting the local area planning in a colony that they must be able to control the spread of this virus within their community, within their geographical areas, and as well as provide relief to those who get infected. So both things are going side by side.
Right. Okay. Mr. Prabhu, challenges and tasks ahead?
The major challenge is making people understand the various regulations that is going to come up in due course of time. Because 2 months, it was because of the pressure or whatever, it has now burst like anything. Now people have become unrest. They are psychologically, mentally, they're disturbed. And if the chairman secretary tries to say something, you don't dictate terms to me. I understand what it is. So the ego has started clashing and the rift has started coming. And every now and then, at least in every building, one or two matters are going to the police station. Police are also finding it really difficult, and the chairman secretary is also finding it difficult, and the managing the show, that is of the day-to-day affairs, also is coming a very big challenge, because people are not paying the maintenance. They are not getting the salaries. They are not doing it. So right. The societies who are not having the money, they are having a more expenses, but the income side is less. This is going to be a big challenge. Of course, containing and retaining, or rather controlling the disease itself, is going to be a big challenge.
Right. Mr. Goyal, you wanted to?
Yeah, I would like to add here that the leadership of the RWA, or what you say, the community leaders, we must get a guidelines, clear guidelines, and the set of rules and norms from the government how to behave under this pandemic. So that way, whatever hanky-panky the community leaders are trying to, that egoistic power, that will not prevail. The second, I will say, whenever there is a disaster, people come, like say if there is an earthquake in Alang, Bhuj, and people came out collecting the food stuff, collecting something and sending it across to them. It is more than that. Now it is a life-saving within your own home. So forget about those who are paying you subscription or those who are not paying you subscription. As a community leader, you have to come for the humanity. You have to stand up for the humanity and work towards saving each and every precious life in your area.
Right. Mr. Goyal, Mr. Prabhu, thank you very much for joining me. And I wish you and your associations and societies all the very best. And we hope we can all fight this together. Thank you very much for joining me.